Hachette Audio presents The House on Sunrise Lagoon, Book 2, Marina in the Middle. Written by Nicole Melleby, performed by Taylor Meskimen. The second rule of boating: always be mindful of other boaters. Chapter 1. Marina Ali-O'Connor watched her sister Samantha stand at the edge of the dock in their backyard. Sam had a small, ugly stick in her hand, one of Mom's old fishing rods, which she kept reeled up. Small fish had been jumping in the lagoon all morning, leaving ripples behind on the surface of the water. This had the Ali-O'Connor's Great Dane, Good Boy, barking his head off, so he had since been banished inside. So far, Sam had caught nothing. She cast her line for the 100th time and slowly reeled it back in. All 5 of the Ali-O'Connor siblings, as soon as their hands were big enough to hold a fishing pole, had been taught how to bait, how to cast, and how to reel to catch many different kinds of fish. "Sam, you're too close to the edge," Marina said from her perch farther back. Marina, at 10 years old, was a year younger than her sister, but she seemed to have much better self-preservation skills. Plus, she wasn't yet used to seeing Sam standing on the deck without a life jacket on. Sam had just recently learned to swim. She'd been the only one of the Ali-O'Connor siblings who hadn't known how. Marina couldn't even remember learning. She'd just always been able to. Their moms made sure the kids learned as soon as possible. Water safety was important, and Mom was chock full of rules to make sure no one would ever get hurt. Especially since the Ali-O'Connors lived in a house right on the water in New Jersey. Instead of a backyard with grass, they had a deck, a dock, and the lagoon. Mom's 3 boats were tied up to the dock. The Sunrise Princess, which Mom used to charter fishing expeditions, was the largest. Harbor Me was the boat they used most often as a family to take rides across the bay. And Raggedy Ann was the smallest, the oldest, the most rusted and busted. According to Marina, Raggedy Ann was nothing more than a death trap. Mom didn't seem to agree. Though in Marina's opinion, all the boats were giant floating death traps. "Sam, you're too close! Step back!" The shout caused Sam to cast an awful line, and she groaned, reeling it back in. "Stop, Marina. I'm fine." Marina didn't understand why Sam, who had until recently been so afraid of swimming, didn't seem to be afraid of anything now that she'd learned how. It was like a switch had been flipped the moment Sam successfully made it across the bay unassisted, and every single thing she was scared of had disappeared. Marina wished she could access her switch. Lately, it had been flipped in the exact opposite direction. "Sam! You aren't my mom, Marina!" "Oh, hey now!" Mama's voice rang out along the back deck. Voices carried easily across Sunrise Lagoon. It was why they always knew exactly what their across-the-way neighbor, Brenda Badger, was thinking. It was why they knew that Jamie Perez, the teenager who lived a few houses down, got in trouble for missing her curfew all the time. And until about a week ago, it was why they couldn't do anything without sending the Patels' dog into a frenzy. The Patels had lived in the house on the corner, but they'd recently moved. The Ali-O'Connors would miss the Patels, but nobody on Sunrise Lagoon would miss their dog. "As one of your actual moms, who wants to tell me what the trouble is out here?" Mama asked. Even though breakfast had been over for a while, Mama was still dressed in a pair of Mom's plaid pajama pants. They were too big on her narrow waist, sitting low on her hips. She always stole Mom's clothes. She claimed they were more comfortable. Marina is smothering me, Sam said. Sam's too close to the edge and not even wearing a life vest, and she's only been swimming for, like, not even a month, and... Sweet girl, it's not your job to police your siblings, Mama said. Marina had been known to carry on forever if they let her. You let us worry about Sam. But no buts, Mama said. Though also, Sam, I would appreciate a heads up if you're going to be out here. You're still a new swimmer, and I'd like to keep an eye on you. Yes? Marina resisted the urge to stick out her tongue and say, I told you so. Yeah, okay, Sam mumbled. She turned her back on them to cast again. Mama stayed outside to watch for a bit. Sam, with her white blonde hair and freckled pale skin, was the odd one out of the three of them. Besides Sam, the only other blondes in the family were Harbor, the oldest Ali-O'Connor sibling by 4 months, and Mom, their other mom. Not that Marina looked very much like Mama when you looked close enough. Sure, they both had dark hair. Mama's, though, was a rich black, and it was curly, just like the twins. Marina's was every shade of brown, thick and wavy. She barely knew how to handle it, even though it was hers. Currently, it was piled up high on her head in a ginormous bun. The twins, like Mama, were part Syrian. Sam was Dutch, just like her biological grandmother, who was currently living in an assisted living home. Harbor was half German from Mom and half Italian from her dad. Marina was, according to her adoption records, Mexican from her birth mom and something else from her birth dad. She didn't know what that something else was, since her birth dad's name wasn't in the records, and all her papers said was that she was mixed race. That was what happened sometimes when you were adopted as a baby, like she was. The back door slammed open against the wall of the house. The twins, 7-year-old Lear and Cordelia, the youngest Ali-O'Connors, came barreling out. They ran barefoot across the deck, Good Boy following at their heels and barking loudly. Mama, there's a moving truck, yelled Cordelia. She had the loudest voice of them all, so now the entirety of Sunrise Lagoon had been alerted to the truck's appearance. Don't run on the deck, Marina shouted back. Her heart was beating faster and faster as she watched the twins. Cordelia especially was prone to spills, and the deck was made of wood panels that were easy to trip on. No running on the deck was one of Mom's rules, and the twins knew better. Mama, tell them! We're not running, we're just standing here, Cordelia said, after they had come to a stop on the other side of Mama. Mama shot them a look, one that said, Your sister is right, but I'm not taking her side right now. At least, that was Marina's interpretation. Most of the time, she was certain that Mama loved the twins best. Relax, sweet girl, Mama said. She wrapped an arm around Marina's shoulders, but Marina shoved it off. We should go to the park instead of worrying about the new neighbors, Marina said. She was always trying to convince her family to go to the park a couple blocks away. It was located by the boat ramp, where everyone launched their boats into the lagoon, but it was far enough away from the water to feel safe. Do you think the new neighbors will have kids? Cordelia asked, pointing across the lagoon to where the Patels had lived. There was, indeed, a large white moving truck parked there. Maybe, Mama said. Marina was doubtful. The Ali-O'Connor siblings made up almost the entirety of the child population on Sunrise Lagoon, other than Jamie Perez, who was 17 and pretended the Ali-O'Connors didn't exist, and the three Badger brothers, George, Sonny, and Pork, who stayed with their grandparents for the summer. The Badgers would be here for only 2 more weeks before they would go back to Staten Island to start school again. Harbor, who was best friends with Sunny Badger, was growing increasingly grumpier as that date grew closer. And Harbor was already the grumpy.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.